Welcome to the subreddit Surviving Infidelity. Today we have two stories. One is about a man who has lost feelings for his cheating ex-wife and he's scared. One is about a woman who found her cheating ex on Tinder. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Story 1. Wife of 5 years cheated and now I feel absolutely nothing for her. Nothing. And that scares me. Here are the key details. My 34, wife, 32, Wendy, and I met through friends 7 years ago, dated for 2 years and have been married for 5 years, just after I finished law school. I worked my tail off as an associate at my firm, putting in 60 hours a week for the first 2 years of our marriage. That effort paid off and I'm doing well professionally. Wendy was a teacher at a private school, but as soon as we got married, she quit so she could go back to school for her master's in education and is currently in an educational doctoral program while working part-time. This was a bit of financial strain, since I wanted to pay off my student loans as quickly as possible, but we managed. My wife had an old laptop that she was using when we started dating. I found it in a box in a closet. She said it crashed and wouldn't work any longer. I plugged it in, tried to turn it on. Nothing. When we met, Wendy took pictures of everything, primarily selfies of her with others. Knowing that she must have had some pictures of us from that time, I yanked the hard drive and looked at it. It seemed okay. The problem must have been somewhere else. Wanting to surprise her with pictures of when we first started dating, I waited until she left to go visit her sister before I plugged it into a SATA cable connector to my PC. There were pictures there, plenty of pictures. Some were of us on dates, laughing, smiling. They brought back some good memories. But there were also others of her with different people. One person in particular I remembered. His name was Bob, and Wendy had dated him before me. There were lots of pictures of her and Bob. I wanted to grab only our pictures, so I thought the easiest way would be to organize them by date, figuring the latest pictures would be of only us. But when I clicked them by date, a lot of her pictures with Bob were jumbled up with pictures of us. I began to open the pictures one by one and noticed that in a few of her pictures with Bob, where they were cuddling and kissing, she was wearing a necklace, locket that I had given her as a birthday present in the second year we were dating. I had to borrow the money from my brother to buy it. I looked at the dates on the pictures and a pattern emerged, on the days and weekends when school required my undivided attention. The times when she went to her mother's house, or her sister's house, to give me peace and quiet, she was meeting up with Bob behind my back. I was furious. It felt like fire ants were chewing on my brain, my heart, in my guts. I wanted to punch through the walls, but, then, something snapped and I went numb. I began to see and think in very cold, analytical terms. I copied all of her pics, all of them, not just those I'd seen, to a flash drive. I packed a bag, grabbed some suits, took the thumb drive and went to stay with my brother across town. I left her laptop hard drive plugged into my PC with a picture of her kissing Bob on the monitor. The only note I left behind was a sticky note with an arrow on it pointing to the necklace, locket. Wendy tried to call me from her mother's house, if that's where she really was, but I didn't answer. It wasn't until a few hours later, after she presumably got back to our apartment and saw the picture on the monitor, that she blew up my phone with VMs and texts. I ignored them all. I've already met with another associate who works in the family law department about separation and divorce. We have no children or real property, since a lot of our money went to paying off my loans and for her tuition. My firm circled the wagons around me so her calls go to VM. She's not allowed onto the property, security already turned her away. Wendy tracked me down at my brother's house, but he made it clear to her on the phone that if she tries to come over, he'll set his Dobermans on her. He told me she was screaming, sobbing, and begging on the phone. It didn't make me sad or happy or anything. I felt nothing. My marriage is over, I've accepted that. But it's been 2 days and I still feel nothing. No pain, no anger, nothing. How is it possible that I have no more feelings for her, no desire to ever see her again, no desire to reconcile? Now that I'm alone with my thoughts, feeling this nothing for her scares me. Is this going to last? Am I still in shock? Am I permanently broken? The upside is that I've never seen clearer solutions in my cases. Comment 1. I am sorry, man, this happened to you. A good thing is that you found out before any children involved. I am not going to lie, man, I would do the same thing and never look back, though I think eventually you will meet with her and her sob story. I was lonely, it was nothing, I realized I love only you, etc. A person capable of hurting you that way worth not another second of your life. As for feeling nothing, is the shock of finding out that the person you loved never existed. Is a self-defense mechanism that unfortunately will wear off and the pain will come. Shield yourself with loved ones to get through it. Mourn her then like she died. And move on to someone worthy. Comment 2. It's only been 2 days. Maybe you are still in shock. Best advice at this point would be individual counseling. Good luck. Comment 3. Sounds like shock. Not the same situation, but lost my dad when I was young, 6 months of numbness. Your body is working so you can function. It's probably that or breakdown. The breakdown will come. Might not be today or tomorrow, but it will hit you. Make sure you got some supports in place if and when it happens. So sorry. Comment 4. I believe you're still in shock. Betrayal does quite a number to your mental health. The sudden intensity of emotions prob put you in a numb state of mind. I've seen posts where people have stayed in a numb state until the act of serving divorce papers causes them to have a breakdown of sadness and anger. I believe you've entered a type of survival mode. I think maybe you have a bunch of questions that you believe won't be answered truthfully. So you've skipped that step entirely and have locked her out so she can't hurt you any more than she has already. It's still fresh, so it isn't uncommon to still be in this state of shock. Infidelity has trauma-like tendencies, where you will find yourself triggered by stuff you never thought twice about before. The fact it happened quite a bit ago makes the hurt almost unbearable, because you feel used and wonder if any of it was real and if she had any other partners. One of the issues is, if she kept this a secret for so long, what else could she be hiding? It is safe to assume, she won't readily admit to anything else if she thinks all of the evidence no longer exists. Hang in there, sorry you going through this. Comment 5. Don't worry, bro, you already take good decision. And it's your wake up call, bro. God save your remaining life. Don't forgive her. She cheating with you in dating time, that's proof only you get, maybe she currently cheating on you. Focus on your future and health. Definitely in future you will get best loyal life partner. Cheater always cheating. Keep update. Story 2. Some satisfaction in knowing I wasn't the problem. Tonight I saw my ex on Tinder. The same ex that left me for a fair partner last year during the start of the pandemic. He threw away 9 years together for what he said was the greatest person ever. Well, I guess she wasn't so great after all, huh? I got some closure knowing that he'll keep void filling his entire life. He went from me to a fair partner with no time in between, and now he's back on dating apps since their fling didn't work out. Or he's actually still with her and secretly cheating on her as well. At the end of the day, it doesn't matter anymore. I'm free and haven't felt true peace like this since before we were together. Cheating is never the BS's fault. I now completely understand that. Comment 1. Yeah, a little vindication is all right, there's something healing about watching it crash and burn, but not too much because you're done with that shite. Just a little smile then on about your day is very appropriate. Comment 2. I'm going to go with the latter. He's jumping from woman to woman. Once a cheater, always a cheater. Comment 3. He gave you a gift by letting you see who he was. Yes, he took 9 years from you, but he gave you back the rest of your life. Think about what you said. He is either broken up with the affair partner or cheating on her. This is who your ex is and you should believe that. Do not give him another thought because he doesn't deserve your thoughts. You have no idea what he is doing or has done to the affair partner. Heaven knows the damage he is going to do to the next person on Tinder. You are free from this. You had a cancer. Now you are cancer-free. Live your life and find happiness. Comment 4. Oh, can relate. Mine was 10 years and they are still together though, I think. Happy that you made it. Comment 5. He is a broken person. You don't need a project, you want a partner. Turned out he wasn't a partner, but a project. Thanks for listening.